This is Smart Money with Pat Boyle and Julia Anderson.
Hi, I'm Julia Anderson here at Smart Money, where we talk about all things money. My co-host Pat Boyle and I are going to be talking to Tobias Reed, Oregon State Treasurer, about a really important program that Oregon is taking the lead on called OregonSaves. And this is your second appearance about OregonSaves, and I know a year ago you were just getting the program rolling. So I guess the first thing is, remind us what OregonSaves is all about, and then give us a little rundown on where we are.
Great, thanks for having me back.
Sure.
We're really excited about OregonSaves because it's allowing people to take control of their own financial future. It's an opt-out IRA for the tens of thousands of people, hundreds of thousands even in Oregon, who don't have a retirement savings plan at work. What we know is that if you do have that access to a plan, you're much more likely to participate and put money away for your future. If you don't, it can seem intimidating, it can seem complicated, and a lot of people don't get started. So we're working really hard to remove all those barriers and give people the confidence to take that first step of investing in themselves. So this is how it works. We passed a law in Oregon that says to employers, if you don't offer a retirement plan, your obligation is to facilitate OregonSaves. And what that means is that employers say to employees, unless you tell me otherwise, 5% of your wages are going into your IRA. Now it's important to realize that that's an individual retirement account. It's owned by the person, follows them from job to job, and they're in control. It's their money. They can do with it as they like. So some people change, some people opt out, but most people are staying in, about 70% of people. And in just under 2 years, they've collectively saved more than $22 million. But as much as you can get lost in those numbers, what's I think even more important is the feeling and the confidence that's giving people. So people who've not known how to save, who've not gotten started on that, you can ask them, what the experience is like, and watch them light up as they say things like, "I feel like I'm getting ahead. There's a path for me," and
I
think that's what most people like about it.
Now, the way you rolled this out is you started with larger businesses,
yes,
just a few, and then you're working your way down to smaller businesses, as small as how many employees?
The legislation says anyone who is employed for compensation in Oregon. So ultimately, everyone should have access.
Okay.
Do you know the 30% that have opted out? Are you hearing why they have? I mean, you would think, why wouldn't I want to save money?
Yes. Yes, we ask that question, and the number one response is, I can't afford to save right now. And that's understandable. There are people who also talk about their spouse or their partner or somewhere else they're saving. Mm-hmm. And that's fine. But we really want to give people the message that even a little bit is powerful. It's really important. And I think that's backed up by numbers. When you think about the power of this program is, I think, going to be revealed in decades when someone who's just starting their career gets in that habit of saving and putting some of their income towards retirement, it can really add up over time. So even if it's just a little bit, there's a powerful message, right, and a powerful trend in that.
How many employers are involved at this point?
At this point, we're about 3,500 employers who have registered, and that goes up a little bit each week. Presently, we're at about $2.6 million a month that's added to the total, but that continues to accelerate as we add more employers and more employees.
And how long will it take to roll it out completely?
We're going to be in about a year or so.
Just a year.
Yeah. Okay. It'll take time, too. If people might decide early on that they don't want to participate right now, but maybe they go to another employer, maybe their circumstances change. And I think what we've seen as the program rolls out is increasing confidence, increasing positive reactions as people have had this experience. And say, hey, this is pretty easy. It's getting me forward in my path towards retirement. And I think we'll continue to see greater levels of support.
Is there a possibility for employers to say, hey, I want to contribute to this as well? Or is it just the employee on his or her own?
Unfortunately, employers are not allowed to match because it's an IRA. We had to structure this in a way that fit with federal law, the ERISA Act from 1974.
The ERISA
Retirement
Act.
Income Security Act. It is a really complicated and obscure piece of federal legislation, but we had to fit within that. My hope is that this program, we're the first in the country to do it, but we're not alone. Illinois, California, a number of other states are moving this direction. So my hope is that this secure choice, as it's known generally, could follow the path of the college savings plans, where individual states innovated, and eventually the federal government recognized that, sanctioned it in a more official way, and allowed for other options. So maybe we'll be back in a few years, and as smart money continues to grow, and we'll be able to talk about even more new features. We've heard that question from a number of employers who would like to match, and mm-hmm. I hope that someday we'll be able to say that's possible.
Good. So just to be clear, the money going into the Oregon Saves account out of the employee's mm-hmm. paycheck mm-hmm. Can be as high as 5%?
That's the standard path. So if you don't tell us anything else,
then
it's
5%.
And a couple more important features that there's also an auto escalate feature. So a year later, if you don't tell us, it'll go to 6%.
Oh, really?
And then up to 7, it stops at 10. But at any point, any individual can change that to whatever makes sense for them. So if you look at the entire population now, the average is about 5.6%. So it's a little above the standard path. Some people are at 1, some people are at 50. It depends on their circumstance. But if you don't tell us anything else, we're going to start at 5.
Many families have that family emergency where operation, whatever, mm-hmm. car breaks down. Mm-hmm. How punitive is it if you have to dip into it?
Well, this is what's a really interesting and important point. That's we decided to make it a Roth IRA on the standard path. So these contributions are after tax. And as a result, there is no penalty if you have to withdraw it. And that's a really interesting feature of what's been our experience so far. So some people, we're not trying to promote it as an emergency fund because it's really intended for retirement, mm-hmm. but it has functioned as an emergency fund for people. And that's certainly better than a payday loan or a title loan or some of those other things. The positive outcome has also been that people who have used dollars for those emergency purposes are generally not taking all that's in the account out. And even if they're doing that, most people are continuing to save in the program. So so another example of how we're giving people better financial choices.
Okay. Why did Oregon decide to do this? Why is Oregon Saves so important?
It's important because as many as half of the people who are working in Oregon don't have access to a retirement savings plan. And if you think about it, that ability to save can have a huge impact on what a person's choices are as they approach retirement. On top of that, we all have a stake in that because when people have assets, when they have choices, they're going to be less of a stretch for a state budget that we know is already pretty stretched. So I think we're all going to benefit when people are empowered to save their own money more easily
for retirement.
Yeah.
So I've heard you and others use the word crisis, in that this country is really in a retirement crisis because people don't have those pensions anymore that used to be guaranteed by the employer that they work for 40 years.
Yep.
And instead, we are now being asked to do a 401k, or now through Oregon Saves you can save. But not enough people are doing it. So we really need to pay attention.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, the gap between what has been saved and what needs to be saved is trillions of dollars.
You're right.
Nationally, it's a real problem. And again, it goes back to what's totally understandable from the point of human nature. You know, when it's complicated, when it feels like it's way off, even
Love
if it isn't,
off.
Yeah, it's easy to say I'll get to that later. I'll figure that out at another point. And we don't. So we're really building on a concept that won Richard Thaler the Nobel Prize in economics. He describes himself, he and his co-author, as libertarian paternalists.
You can
preserve choice, but we want to make it easier for you to do what's in your own best interest.
So how are you marketing Oregon Saves?
Every way we can.
What are you doing? What are you
here now?
Do this.
Yeah, absolutely. We're very entrepreneurial. We're very grassroots. We go talk to everybody. We have a modest amount to talk in broader channels on television and on the on radio and internet sorts of things. But this power of opt out rather than opt in really helps.
That's a big deal.
It flips the script and turns the inertia we've already identified as a problem in ordinary circumstances into something of an ally. Mm-hmm. So if you don't do anything, you're going to be saving, and that's what allows for 70% of people
to participate. That's a little more assertive. on the state's part.
Well, yeah, but it's, I would argue, and I think we see this as a you know, as a positive for people. Mm-hmm. DHM did a poll, I think it was last fall, that measured public support. It's actually gone up since we passed the legislation. It's now 82% of people who support Oregon Save. So that I think that it may be a little more assertive, but mm-hmm. but people like it and
right.
they need it.
Yeah.
Do you ever get any Big Brother pushback, like, what, you're going to tell me I have to save 6%, then 7%, then 8%? Can I decide that?
Absolutely you can. And the answer is yes, you can decide that. You can change it to any amount, including zero, that you want to.
Now, you were before Congress not too long ago, right? What was the committee that you testified for?
The Senate Finance Committee.
Wow. Yes. Yeah. And so what did they want to know from you? Why did they ask you to come and talk to them?
Well, I think those senators recognized the national significance of this issue, and I was there with a few other people. The title or the subject of the hearing was about what solutions there are for the retirement savings crisis. And I was happy to tell a story of what we've done in Oregon and what lessons we've learned. People were asking about that. What could Congress learn from that? What could individual states do? And it was fun to tell the story.
So do you think there would be any federal legislation come out of this that would maybe modify that, what did you say, RESA? that law?
ERISA.
ERISA, yeah, that's it.
Well, it's funny you use RESA, you know, that, because there is a bill in Congress that's
is
also
called RESA.
And it's,
yeah,
and it's this very subject.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I think there's lots of reason to hope and expect that Congress will take some action on these topics generally. So part of the message for me was, you know, here are the lessons we've learned, and I think Congress should take some action on that. Mm-hmm. But as you do, senators, please make sure you allow states like Oregon to continue doing the work we're doing, crafting
sure.
our own solutions and responding sure. to our constituents.
So let's review then.
Sure.
So Oregon Saves is a statewide program for employees who work for businesses that do not offer a retirement plan, a 401k or something like it. Is
true.
That right?
And I need to add one important point to
okay.
that, because there are certainly a number of people who have who are part of the gig economy or self-employed.
That's right.
And they can self-enroll into Oregon Saves as well.
Oh, that's helpful,
great.
Isn't it?
It is. So
that's
you
a really
get
important
access
thing.
To that large pool yeah. and be part of this pool. We have hundreds of people who are doing that as well.
Okay, and how do we find out more about this?
I bet you can guess the URL, OregonSaves.com.
Yes.
It has
okay.
nothing to do with ERISA then, right?
There you go.
Right.
Well, thank you so much, Oregon State Treasurer Tobias Reed, for bringing us up to date on Oregon Saves. And you can find out more at OregonSaves.com. And thanks again for being with us.
Thank you.
Thank you.
For more information, go to my website at 60andsingle.com. We'll be right back.